Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Melissa Mistel, and I am your Master of Ceremonies today. In case of an emergency, please take note of your closest emergency exit and follow all instructions given by the venue staff. I ask now for gentlemen to please remove your hats, bonnets and mortarboards and join us in singing the first verse of the Australian National Anthem.
Australians, oh, let us rejoice, for we are young and free. We've golden soil and wealth for toil. Our home is girt by sea. Our land abounds in nature's gifts of beauty, rich and
Graduates and guests, welcome to the first CQUniversity Cairns graduation ceremony. Please return your hats, bonnets or mortarboard, gents. And please be seated. At CQUniversity, our graduation ceremonies are all about the celebration of achievements. We would love you to cheer out loud as your friend or family member crosses the stage today. You will notice that the university mace is located centre stage. The mace is a symbol of the authority of the council of the university and signifies the university's responsibility to work for the sustenance of our present world and to ensure that future generations are not disadvantaged but enriched by our efforts. I now invite Associate Professor Henrietta Murray to deliver the Welcome to Country.
Thank you. Welcome to Kimawalbra Yirinji Country. Ngayu Bilan Gudanyundu, Kimawalbra Yirinji Jabu. Welcome you all to the country of the Kimawalbra Yirinji people. Today we meet for a great first occasion to celebrate with CQ University, the graduates and their families on Yirinji Country, a meeting place for many years, for many different ceremonies. 140 years ago, these lands were settled. My people once walked these lands, fished in the rivers, gathered medicine and food from our rainforest, and practiced their ancient traditions and customs. I want to acknowledge and welcome to Gimoy, the Chancellor, Dr. Robin Mitchington, and the Vice Chancellor, Professor Hilary Winchester, and CQ University Cairns Associate Vice Chancellor, Ms. Jodie Dugan-George, and Professor Bronwyn Fredericks from the Office of Indigenous Engagement, CQU, and to every one of our deans and principals here at the schools. Welcome to all of those who have travelled to Cairns for this special occasion, and of course to graduates. I pay my respect to our Jabaja Gupi, our land spirit, who will keep you safe in your travels. This area we meet this afternoon is at the Wari mouth of the Burawangal, which is Trinity Inlet. And this is the start of the Gimoy Wallaroo Yirinji Women's Dreaming Songline. It is the birthplace of our great warrior, Kuyum, whose songline travels up to Sabai Island in the Torres Straits and on to New Guinea. Here also lies our clan totem, Ginjara, the cassowary, which is Admiralty Island. We are surrounded by the spirits of the ocean, Burumbaja, and the reef, Jurubinja, and our mangroves, Garbaraja, and of course the rainforest, Dulguja, and our land, the Jabuja Gupi. Our great cultural story sites of the north are Bundajambunji Ranges, and to the west of us, Bundamundagunji, as we know as White Rock, and to the south of us, Bundajarigan, the Walsh Pyramid, and to the east of us, Burawango. These great landscape speaks to us and reminds us who we are. They give us our laws and our customs. They remind us that we must not lose our connection to this great Jabuja, that we need to strengthen the connections with our gupi, our spirit dreamings, that create who we are and our identity as Gima Walbara Yidinji people. Living on our own culture, living our own culture according to our traditions and our laws in our land, this is how we are connected to our country, to our language, to our culture, to our understanding of history and our sense of trust, our wholeness and our relationships with our neighbouring clans. The power that we possess as Yidinji, as individuals and as families, that ability to work together, the unity that we continue to have, is the foundation of everything for our people. It is our understanding of our relationship to nature, to our communications with the spirit world, that is very important to us. This is the path that we as Walbara Yidinji must take to honour the memory of our ancestors and to honour the memory of Yidinji warriors who have sacrificed, fought and died to preserve the integrity of our Yidinji nation. I was once told by my grandfather that if you don't walk your country, if you don't talk or listen to your country, it will not remember you. It will not protect you. I say walk your country, speak to your country, and it will know and protect you. By welcoming you all here this evening is to practice these principles embedded in our ancient laws and our customs. We are one of Australia's ancient cultures and still practice these ancient traditions, a custom which should be the pride for all of us. I wish all the graduates all the best in their future endeavour. And I just want to say my connection to this country is through my father, Quiblum Hendrik Fourmile, my grandfather, Ngayi Quiblum Ted Fourmile, and through my great-grandfather, Yini, a great warrior, a great Nalan and a great warrior, a man that was respected and given its place in the Cairns City Library, a portrait which is there today by one of our former mayors of this of Cairns, and the land of my great-great-grandfathers, Yidiju and Mundijupa. This is the lineage that I come down. We are now eighth generation connected to Grandfather Yidiju in this country that stand here today. And I say to you on behalf of all of my ancestors, Bilan Gudan, welcome to Gimwa.
Thank you, Associate Professor Mari, for that welcome. I would now like to invite our Chancellor, Dr. Robin Minchinson, to deliver the address of welcome today.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, distinguished guests, parents, families, friends and supporters of our graduands, for this very significant ceremony and milestone in your lives. My welcome also to members of council, university staff, and our campus medalist receiving an award today. For the first time in Cairns, we are celebrating the achievements of 18 graduates. In 2012, we opened as a dance education centre and had 393 students. The full campus here, though, opened in 2015 and I was privileged to be present at that opening. Our on-campus teaching started only this year, and we already have 873 students studying, with term three still to go. Graduands, CQ University is now your university. With its beating heart in the regional parts of Australia, it's different to many others, and you will have already discovered as a student that we hold our values very close. And we pride ourselves on being a university engaged with our stakeholders and our communities, having a can-do approach to achieving our goals, being open and transparent with our processes, our decision-making and communications, and modelling leadership in teaching, learning, research, engagement, and indeed in governance, and also demonstrating inclusiveness, defining ourselves by who we include in our university, not who we exclude. And the City of Cairns has included us. We have partnered with CBD businesses to give students access to all the services they might expect from a regional university campus. The Cairns CBD is the university campus. Now, you may not have had time to really think about it, but today is one of a number of important rituals in your lives. We are here to celebrate an occasion of deep importance in our own distinct university way, filled with special customs like the doff, special symbols like the mace you see before you, music, family, elders, strange costumes, emblems of rank and extremely funny hats, all coming together to commemorate a rite of passage for you. As graduands, you have clearly demonstrated the very human qualities of perseverance, commitment, and dedication in order to walk across this stage to graduate today. Be proud of yourselves. Your family, friends, and supporters have worked behind the scenes to enable you to arrive at this place in your lives. University staff, some of whom you see here with me, an outstanding number of university staff, have guided and inspired you through the medium of education to make a better life for yourselves and ultimately for those around you. Your CQ University will enable you to meet extraordinary challenges and reap incredible rewards. But whatever obstacles and opportunities await you, be confident that your time here has prepared you exceptionally well for whatever comes next. We have a university motto. It's on the banners here at either side. It is in Latin, doctrina perpetua, which means lifelong learning or lifelong education. Statistics show us that a new graduate today will pass through up to 7 career changes in their working life. So, while today is a very important educational milestone for you, it's likely that you will need to tune up your qualifications and answer new questions as your careers unfold. And of course, your university, CQ University, would be absolutely delighted to have you back with us to undertake further studies. On behalf of the university, I want to acknowledge and applaud all award recipients today. You have done a fantastic job, and we wish you all the best for a fulfilling and happy future in which you serve and contribute to the community around you. I'd like to wish everyone here today an especially joy-filled day of celebration. Thank you.
Thank you, Chancellor. I would now like to invite our Vice-Chancellor and President, Professor Hilary Winchester, to deliver the opening address.
Thank you. And thank you to the Chancellor and all of you here today helping us celebrate this wonderful occasion. I'd like to add my congratulations to those of the Chancellor, to our 18 graduands here today, but also to their families and those people who have supported them through this journey. And for many of you, it's been quite a long time studying part-time and online, and we know that there's the juggle going on. It's not just silly hats, but there's a juggle of family and study and work, and sometimes life gets in the way. But today is a celebration of your achievements, and it is a real achievement to have got to this point. But I'd just like to say a little bit about the university's achievements here today on the first graduation in Cairns. And this week has just been an amazing one, this last few days for our university. So just last week in Rockhampton, we had a visit from the Deputy Prime Minister, then the Acting Prime Minister, in fact, Barnaby Joyce, and he was opening some renovated agriculture labs for us. So we had the Acting Prime Minister on our campus. We've had visitors, I think we had three other ministers, including one from Papua New Guinea, also in the last week. Yesterday I was in Brisbane, and six of our staff members, both academic and professional staff members, received national citations for excellence in learning and teaching. They were awarded in Brisbane on a state basis. So there was one team of three and three individuals. So that was four citations altogether, four out of just over 100 across the nation. So when there are 40 universities, we're punching above our weight. At Academic Board, just this Monday, we were hearing about how the student satisfaction with our courses, with our teaching, has improved year on year for the last 5 years. And we had little graphs that showed us that. And amazingly, just last Thursday, we heard that we were ranked in the top 500 universities in the world in the Times Higher Education rankings. Now, that is an amazing achievement, as I say, for a regionally based, relatively small, relatively new university. And it's based on 13 million pieces of data. It's been verified by PricewaterhouseCoopers, and all the analysis has been run twice. So there's no doubt about it. And what that reflects is our learning and teaching environment. It reflects our research and our citations, and the citations of research is an indication of impact and reputation. And it also reflects our internationalisation. So that's just a little bit about the achievement that this university has gone through. And coming to Cairns and being part of this is going to assist us in developing that reputation and that impact. And we'll be looking to you as graduates of this university to carry that achievement forward. And we look forward to your input in increasing that reputation and impact as your achievements mount over the years. Thank you.
Thank you, Vice-Chancellor. I would now like to welcome our Chancellor back to the lectern to introduce our guest speaker.
Thanks, Mel. Vanessa Seeky, OAM, and her husband Liberty Seeky are part of a fifth generation Torres Strait family. Vanessa arrived in the Torres Strait in 1994 as a teacher before marrying Liberty in 1999 and having two daughters. Vanessa and Liberty founded Torres Strait Heritage and collectively designed and curate the Horn Island Tours and Museum. In 2001, Vanessa played an important role in the lobby that persuaded the Commonwealth to award the 1939 to 1945 Star Medal to Torres Strait veterans after 60 years waiting, thus giving them access to full veterans' medical benefits. She is currently still campaigning for the veterans to receive full service pensions. In 2005, Vanessa earned a master's degree from CQUniversity with her thesis titled Horn Island, Torres Strait and the 1939 to 45 Star Medal, and was also awarded the Order of Australia Medal for services to the World War II veterans of Torres Strait. Vanessa and Liberty have since established the World War II Torres Strait Conservation Project, which will see World War II sites in the area sensitively conserved. Vanessa and Liberty have written two books, Horn Island in Their Steps, 39 to 45, and Discover Thursday and Horn Islands, co-written with Gordon Grimwade. They have received numerous awards over the last decade and are regular finalists and winners of the Tour and Transport Indigenous Tourism and Cultural Heritage categories in the Queensland Tourism Awards and Tropical North Queensland Tourism Awards. So please join me in warmly welcoming Vanessa to deliver the occasional address.
Good afternoon, Chancellor, ladies and gentlemen, and thank you for that wonderful introduction. My name is Vanessa Seeky, and I am an alumnus of CQ University and founder of Torres Strait Heritage. And it is a great privilege today to be here at the first graduation ceremony as the occasional speaker. Firstly, I'd like to congratulate all the graduates today. Enjoy the day, reflect on your hard work and dedication that brought you here today, but make sure you celebrate your success with your family and friends. Congratulations to the university, the teaching and administration staff who have brought these graduates along their road to this wondrous day. Today is the culmination of years of hard work, patience and perseverance in your chosen fields of study. Your work at CQ University is built upon a passion that you have for your disciplines and has had empowered you with skills and life experiences that you can take on to your chosen careers. You all come from varied disciplines, which is an admirable reflection on the diversities of studies offered at CQ. I encourage you to focus on what you're passionate about and to think outside the box, expand your boundaries, go forward from this ceremony and challenge conformities, be an innovative, ask questions, go beyond the parameters and make success for yourselves and for those around you. Be the difference in people's lives. Don't ever limit yourself. Be imaginative in your thinking, bold in your ideas, and if you find yourself challenged by injustice and indifference, think laterally. Use your passion and your unique skill set to devise a solution. My husband and I have founded Torres Strait Heritage. We conduct the In Their Steps World War II tours on Horn Island. We guide guests, veterans and families, and establish the Torres Strait Heritage Museum, which is the largest collection of its kind in the Torres Strait. The tours are a combination of archival info and veteran stories. We visit hidden gun emplacements, underground rooms, aircraft. Seeing the need for the conservation of these sites, we established the Conservation Project, which will see these sites sensitively conserved. The work in these areas has seen World War II memorials on all the outer islands in the Torres Strait, and a memorial to the 156 men and women and kids who were killed during World War II in Torres Strait. The tours and the museum have thus created a tourism industry on Horn Island, which has in turn led to benefits for the local community and business. So when I first arrived at Horn Island 22 years ago, I'd walk around and find these underground rooms and slit trenches and planes, but nobody could tell me who had put them there, why they were here, what had happened on the island, and I thought it was a travesty that people had been there and done something. They'd worn their nation's uniform and no one knew anything about them. So I started the work, and with persistence, patience and tenacity, was able to source from various different academic collections information about Horn Island and the Torres Strait. Then I found one veteran who served there. He knew five other veterans who served there. So from one veteran, we now have a vast collection of over 300 interviews in our oral database. But importantly, each year between 97 and 2014, we took veterans and their families back to the sites where they served. They got to walk in the steps of their teenage selves and show their families what they had done during the war. One gentleman didn't know about his father's service. He died young. But he found his family's name on a plaque at the conserved 34th Battery site. The family name and the initial matched. Now, I said it was a common name. I wasn't very hopeful. I'd do some research for him. I didn't have to. We got back to the museum. He came bolting outside, tears in his eyes. He'd found his dad's photo in there, in the display of the 34th. So we knew that that was his dad and he had served there. But while speaking with these veterans, it became apparent that they did not receive the medals and the pensions that they were supposed to. There was an anomaly with the 3945 Star Medal, which was given to Darwin veterans who served during the bombings, but not the Torres Strait veterans who had suffered the same bombings. How to change a ruling that was established by the Department of Veterans Affairs? My answer was a thesis, which I undertook through CQUniversity. This thesis, along with lobbying from our local member and veterans communities, enabled the changing of the Veterans Affairs rules, which saw them granted the 3945 Star Medal and which affected their pensions and gold cards. Change and making a difference in people's lives is the most rewarding thing. But it's not a given. Persistence, patience, and resilience will be required. However, the end result can be life-changing for some. One of the greatest gifts is to empower people with knowledge, for it can bring happiness to some and closure to others. Margaret rang me one day. She remembered as a little girl, a man in a uniform and a priest coming to the door. They had come to tell her parents that their only son was killed somewhere in the Southwest Pacific. They never knew the details. He was listed actually as missing for 2 years before he was listed as killed. They didn't know where he was or the circumstances. So I said I'd help her. I did some research, found out that he was indeed, his plane indeed went into the water to the west of Horn Island. Torres Strait had become his eternal home. So I explained this to her and said that he was commemorated in Rookwood Cemetery in Sydney. So she came up to Torres Strait with her family. They flew over the site. They laid a reef. They walked in the steps of their brother on Horn Island. They flew in the sky as he flew. And after 70 years, they had closure. So be compassionate in your work with all the people you work with. Be brave. Endeavour to make that difference in all you do. Make the things you mean do something to someone. Always think, what more can you do? What further step can I take? But these steps won't be isolated ones. Revel in the company of family and friends, those of you who have helped bring you here today. Work towards finding the balance with your work and family life. Cherish the moments of quiet with an appreciation of all that you have. I wish you all meaningful lives full of laughter and love, success and purpose.
Thank you, Vanessa. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to present to you a musical performance by Miss Yasmin Lancini. Yasmin is a graduate of CQ University's Music Theatre Program. Yasmin is a singer, performer and music teacher here in far north Queensland. While studying at the Central Queensland Conservatorium of Music, Yasmin directed the educational theatre touring show, Choices, and performed in musicals such as Chicago and The Sentimental Bloke. Graduating from CQ University Mackay last year, Yasmin was also the recipient of the Associate Vice Chancellor's Mackay Campus Medal. Please welcome Yasmin to the stage. Thank you very much, Yasmin. I'd now like to call up on our Vice Chancellor and Professor again, Professor Hilary Winchester, to present the graduates today.
Will all graduates please stand? Chancellor, as Vice Chancellor and President, I certify to you and to Council, these graduates standing before you today have fulfilled the requirements prescribed by the University, and I ask that you present them with their respective awards.
In the name of the Council and by my authority as Chancellor, I am pleased to present our newest graduates with their awards. Please honour them with your applause.
Will all graduates please be seated?
Thank you, Chancellor and Vice-Chancellor. Chancellor, I now call upon Dr. Malcolm Johnson to present graduates.
Chancellor, I present to you graduates from the undergraduate and postgraduate programs. Bachelor of Building Surveying and Inspection, Jason Edward Hillier. Annette Jutta Sikowski. Michelle Louise Doherty. Kia Tao Lurie. Elisa Crystal Capaldi. Bachelor of Paramedic Science, Caitlin Rose Denning. Bachelor of Paramedic Science with Distinction, Victoria Ann Stevenson. Bachelor of Psychological Science, Lee Schwenke. Bachelor of Science, Industrial Chemistry, Catherine Elisa Barnes. Bachelor of Financial Planning and Bachelor of Accounting, Katie Alexandra Hoyles. Bachelor of Construction Management Honours, Mitchell James Bentley. Graduate Diploma of Midwifery, Cheryl Ann McCluskey. Melissa Subert. Nokuthla Sabanda. Master of Teaching Primary with Distinction, Mami Osada. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of graduates.
I'd now like to call upon Ms. Jodie Dygan-George, Associate Vice Chancellor from Cairns and Far North Queensland Region, to present the Associate Vice Chancellor's Medal for the Cairns Campus.
Chancellor? I'm pleased to present the recipient of the Associate Vice Chancellor's Campus Medal. The medal recognises a student who has demonstrated a combination of the following: a strong commitment to their studies, the ability to respond to challenges, a capacity to act as mentors to other students, a willingness to contribute to the life of the campus, outstanding potential for significant leadership in their future careers, clear commitment to the value of cultural diversity, and creative talent and enterprise. To receive an Associate Vice Chancellor's Campus Medal, who today is graduating with a Masters of Teaching Primary with distinction, I present Mami Osada. Chancellor, that concludes the presentation of the Associate Vice Chancellor's Campus Medal.
Thank you, Jodie. I now call upon Mr. Mitchell Bentley to deliver the response by the graduates' representative.
Good afternoon, Chancellor, Vice Chancellor, guest speaker, Ms. Vanessa Seeke, distinguished guests, CQU staff, fellow graduates and their guests. First of all, thanks must go to guest speaker Ms. Seeke for your time and kind words. Please accept this as a small gift, as a token of our appreciation. It is an honour to give this address today on behalf of the graduating students. We have gathered to be recognised for the commitment and sustained effort required to complete undergraduate and postgrad degrees. Personally, this effort included balancing an aggressive study pathway with full-time work commitments, as well as family life and what was left of a social life. I'm sure many of the graduates have children, and for those, this journey to this milestone would have been even more challenging. On behalf of the graduating students here today, I'd like to acknowledge the efforts of CQU staff and student mentors, to late-night presentations and the flexibility displayed by many of the lecturers, to schedule and reschedule after-hours presentations, tutorials and lectures, is a testament to the quality and commitment of the CQU staff in delivering first-class academic offerings. To my fellow graduates, there have been many sacrifices during the completion of our qualification. Time, money, and some of the most socially productive years of our lives. However, there have been so much gain. We have gained knowledge and appreciation and understanding of how education can change lives and a desire to continue learning. We understand the value of organisation and persistence while having mastered the skill of procrastination. We have learned strategies for goal setting and time management and are well on our way to achieving our career objectives and setting examples for our children and others around us. We should now be alert to pushing boundaries, grasping opportunities, and being exemplary in our endeavours. In today's age, it is ever so important to be adaptable to change, to be flexible and creative, both in a sense of organisational structure and technology. Our university qualifications should give us the confidence and empowerment to think innovatively, as well as the insight to never be afraid to learn, unlearn, and relearn. This is the power of knowledge. We should be passionate about our field of expertise and commit to making positive contributions to the industry we work in and to the wider community. So where to from here? Albert Einstein had some sound advice on that point. Learn from yesterday, live for today, hope for tomorrow. The important thing is to not stop questioning. To my fellow graduates, we are here, we did it, celebrate accordingly. I wish you all the very best. Thank you.
Thank you, Mitchell. I now ask our Chancellor to deliver the charge to graduates today.
I now ask all graduates to please stand, very proudly standing. As newly conferred graduates of CQ University, it is at this stage in the proceedings that we conduct a turning of the tassel ceremony. This is a long-standing university tradition that officially symbolises your transition from graduand to graduate of CQ University. Please now move your tassel on your bonnet or hat from the right side of your mortarboard to the left. So move it to the other side. Very good. I now charge you as graduates of CQ University Australia to maintain a commitment to lifelong learning, to strive for truth, integrity, and compassion, to contribute to your chosen profession, and by the application of your abilities, support and nurture the communities of which you are part. May your rewards bring honour to your university, your chosen profession, and to yourself. Good luck. Now, just before I sit you down, I want you to turn around, face the back of the room, and face all those people who have supported you. And please, with everyone else, acknowledge your families and supporters for your achievements. Well done. Please be seated.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the first ceremony of CQ University Cairns. On behalf of the Chancellor and the staff and management from CQ University Cairns campus, I'd like to thank you for attending today, and I'd like to invite you to join us for refreshments in the foyer following the conclusion of the ceremony. However, for the time being, I ask that you please stand while our official party retires.